In this video, I will guide you through using the API Query Builder to effortlessly request data from the API. Before we get started, be sure that you have registered for an account on the Open Data Portal and are signed in. If you need help with the registration process, check out the video description for a link to a tutorial that can help you with that. To begin, navigate to any dataset page from the data catalog. For this demonstration, I will use an API training dataset. The dataset name is Training Dataset Industries. First, let's learn more about our dataset. Scroll down to the Fields table, and you will see that this dataset has three fields called Industry, Value, and Year. Next, scroll down to the Data Preview. This will give you an idea of what the data look like before you make a request. Finally, scroll down to the API Query Builder, which provides you with a basic template for making API calls and allows you to interactively select which fields and records you want, choose how records are formatted and sorted, and generates an API request that you can use to get your desired data. Because you are already signed into the portal, the Authorize button is green, which indicates that your API key is in use and will be automatically populated into your data requests. If you were not signed in, the Authorize button would be red, which would indicate that you would not be able to request data. Let's start building an API request. Begin by expanding the API Query Builder to view the available parameters for customizing your data request. Format allows you to pick a data format returned by the API. By default, you will get JSON, but you can get CSV or XML instead. I'm going to pick CSV because it is the most efficient output format and is widely usable in most software applications. Limit allows you to specify the maximum number of records returned by the API. By default, you will get 10 records, but you can request up to 5 megabytes of data, not exceeding 10,000 records per request. I'm going to leave it at 10. Offset allows you to specify the number of records to skip from the top of a dataset. This parameter can be used in conjunction with the limit parameter when you are requesting more than the maximum record limit for a dataset. Since we are not requesting more than the maximum record limit, we can leave this at 0. Fields allows you to select specific fields for your request. For example, if you only want industry and value, you can select these fields. This can be very useful at delivering only the data elements you need and reducing the size of data payloads when you are working with big datasets that have lots of variables. If you want all fields, don't make any selections because by default, all fields will be returned. Sort allows you to sort records in ascending or descending order. I'm going to use the default setting, which is set to ascending order. Sort by allows you to sort records by a single field. In this example, I will sort the records by year. Filter object allows you to get a subset of records from the API. Simply pick a pre-populated filter example and edit it. The filter operators we support are equals, not equals, greater than, less than, in, not in, and like. For this example, let's pick equals and filter the dataset records where industry equals A. Next, replace the text, your field, with industry, and your value with A. Now, we are ready to execute the API query. If everything is successful, you will see data in the response body, as well as the response code 200. You will have the option to download the data once directly from the response body, or you can use a curl command or request URL to automate workflows. This allows you to regularly retrieve your customized data requests from the API with the latest available data from our database. This feature distinguishes our API from other data download methods. I am going to use the request URL, which can be executed within a web browser or external software like Python, R, Excel, and dashboarding applications. For simplicity, copy and paste the request URL into a web browser and get your CSV data. Because I have Microsoft Excel on my computer, I can open up this CSV file download as a tabular spreadsheet. Now, you know how to use the API Query Builder to access our data. Try modifying the parameters and rerunning the request on your own. Find more videos like this on our video tutorials page, and don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel.